Hello, Year 4. Now, this week for art, we're going to kind of get ahead of our geography a little bit on map work, and we're going to have a look at something called contour lines. Contour lines are used on maps to show the height of the land above sea level. And so if you have got some land which is a hill or a mountain and you look on the map, you will see contour lines. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about that in geographical wise, and then I'm also going to show you some ideas, some simple and some a little bit more ambitious, that you could try to explore contour lines in your artwork. So very simply, on maps, contour lines show the contour of the land from mountains and gullies, and the lines show the height of the land above the sea level. They're often accompanied by a number, which is usually the number of meters above sea level. So if you looked at the legend or the key on the map, then it would show you that. So the diagram here shows you what the mountain would look like in as a 3D model, and then below it, if you were just to see the contour lines drawn on a flat piece of paper. But now we're going to just hear from a bit of an expert, a little bit of a geography on how contour lines work on maps.
When you're out and about, it's really useful to get a sense of the shape and height of the surrounding landscape. And on an OS map, you do that using contour lines. These are the faint reddish-brown lines you can see running across here. And eventually, you come to a number that'll give you the height above sea level of that particular line. And that line is running between interconnected points of the same height. The difference in between contour lines is going to be 5 meters or 10 meters, and you can tell that by looking at the legend on your map. Here, on a shallow slope, the contour lines will be far apart. When you visit somewhere like this, the contour lines are much closer together to show a much steeper slope. With a bit of practice, you can look at a two-dimensional map like this and start to get in your head a complete three-dimensional picture of what the landscape looks like. And that's a really important tool in navigation.
Have to charge. Fantastic, so we're all complete experts now. And so we just learned that when the lines are quite far apart, then the slope on the land is quite shallow, quite gradual slope, whereas when the lines are very close together, it's a really steep mountain. So one of the options for you today with your art is just to simply look at some of the contour line maps that I have included on the virtual school, and to colour them in any way you like. I think they're just quite beautiful in their own right, and I've shown one there as an example, which is sort of quite accurate to a geographical way, because the colours show the height of the land. So you could do it like that if you want, or you can make it more like a piece of mindfulness colouring, and you can choose the colourings yourself. And there are quite a few different choices of those to choose from. So I hope you enjoy them. For information, another name for this kind of map is a topographical map. If I can get it out, a topographical map. I said it better the first time. So that's one option for you this week. Oh, as another alternative, you could really explore the 3D nature of contour lines. So this paper model here has been made using different coloured card, which have been cut out, and each layer is getting smaller as you move towards the peak of the hill or the mountain. So you might like to make a really great model of a mountain using contour lines using paper. You could even use modelling clay to do a model in a similar way. And I thought I'd just put that picture there of the squares with concentric circles by Kandinsky, which I'm sure you'll be familiar with, because I thought that the colours on that were really great, and also the circles do really remind me of those contour lines of mountains. So I'm giving you lots of inspiration this week, and I would like you to come up with a piece of artwork of your own which is inspired by contour lines. So good luck. I really can't wait to see what you come up with.
John with the wolf.